All right, if there's one skill I've found to be critical to being a data analyst or to many other jobs nowadays, is learning how to apply analytical thinking. Go through most job applications today, you'll find must have the ability to apply analytical thinking. When I was much younger in my college days, I had the opportunity to take math classes. And now that I work as a data analyst, I've come across other data analysts that never took math classes in college. And that made me realize that math is only just one of the many ways to develop one's analytical thinking skills, which is why in this video, I'm going to highlight three familiar ways you can use to develop your analytical thinking skills. What's up, guys? Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Wale, and I'm a data analyst based in Lagos, Nigeria. On this channel, we explore tips and strategies to become better at work and life. It happens that I'm a data analyst, so I talk more about data analysis. If this is something you're into, do like and subscribe so that you don't miss any new content. So what is analytical thinking skills and why do we need it? Analytical thinking is the process of breaking down complex problems in a logical way to develop solutions. This process usually involves collecting data, analyzing data, and developing solutions. So when we're in the workplace or generally in our everyday lives, we're often faced with problems that do not have obvious solutions. So let's say you are the manager of a local grocery store, or perhaps you own an online business and you want to know why your sales revenue has been reducing over the past 3 months. The first thing you want to do is to review your sales records to see your month-on-month revenue. While at that, you realize that sales figures for your top-selling product, the one that drives your revenue, has been declining. Reason why your total sales revenue has been declining. You do a bit more analysis on your customer data and you've discovered that many of your customers do not return to buy other products after their first purchase. Now that you have found the problem, the next process is to develop a solution to the problem. So perhaps you decide to take a survey of your customers to get their feedback on their last purchase, or you decide to start a new marketing campaign to reach new customers. Whatever you choose to do, what you've accomplished is your ability to apply analytical thinking to the problem. So you collected information around the problem, you analyzed the information, and then you made a decision based on your analysis. Now, this is no different to the other types of situations we face daily, whether it is how we manage our money, time, or resources. And so to develop your analytical thinking skills, here are the top three things you can do. So the first is to take an analytics course. This is by far the easiest and the fastest way to improve and sharpen your analytical thinking skills. Taking a course in something you find interesting opens your mind up to learning and picking new information. This holds true when you take on something new, perhaps a new challenge, something you've never done before. Right now, I'm taking the IBM Data Analyst Certificate with a focus on the Python for Data Science, AI, and Development course, which I'm going to be reviewing in a future video. The second thing you want to do is to learn to play games, brain games or video games. Something very powerful about games is the ability to make, you know, the player keep a constant attention towards it. And not just that, you also must make inputs to the game so you can make progress and continue to stay in the game. This is a great way to stimulate our brains, improve our analytical thinking skills while having fun doing so. So brain games like Sudoku, puzzles, chess, or video games that require you to have a strategy will help you to think logically and improve your problem solving skills. I have found chess to be my preference because while I was younger, I used to play with my brother, whom I used to beat, but now I seem to have lost a bit of steam. The third thing you can do is to read more frequently. I used to find reading very difficult early on. I had my initial struggles of not being a committed reader. I was the type that would only buy books when I walked past a bookstore. And as much as I wanted to read, I would not necessarily go out of my way to buy a book, which is typical for a lot of people. And this was the case not until I got myself a Kindle, which then opened me up to a wide range of options to choose from. Now, with the option of listening through a book instead of reading the book, I find reading easy and read the entire reading experience a whole lot better. Two books that I'm currently reading now is Finish What You Start by Peter Hollins and Build a Career in Data Science by Emily Robinson and Jacqueline Nollis. If you do not have the means to buy books, an alternative is to listen to podcasts that invokes analytical thinking. Most phones now come with a podcast app, which is totally free to use. iPhone comes with an Apple Podcast. Android users also have a free built-in podcast app where you can browse and search for content based on your interest. And just like books, the choice of content here is unlimited, so find what you like and dive in. Obviously, there are many other ways to develop your analytical thinking skills, such as being more observant, asking questions, thinking about your decisions. I found this great quote by Idris Seha that says, "Learn to be as analytical about things of which you are credulous as you are of those which you criticize." In other words, it's easy to be analytical about things that we do not like than the things that we like. If you think about the energy we spend to be analytical about things like sports, politics, and then think about how much energy we spend being analytical about our own selves, you'll find that there's a huge disparity there. So take some time out to do some bookkeeping, check out your finances, how much are you spending monthly, how much calories do you consume daily if that is something you are concerned about. The good thing is there are apps that can help you with some of these things. So apps for budget tracking, apps for calorie tracking, or even your wearables for sleep tracking. You can use whatever tool you have to start collecting data about yourself that you can analyze and use to make informed decisions. So the whole idea is for you to pay more attention to yourself, and then your mind becomes sensitive to analytical thinking. Surely, I hope you find the time to practice one or a combination of these three things. Let me know down in the comment section which one of the three tips you would like to start with or which one you're currently practicing. If you have questions, do leave them down in the comment section below. I'll be happy to answer them. If you want to learn about how to begin your journey as a data analyst, then you should watch this video here where I talk about the beginner's guide to data analysis and what courses to start with. Or if you want to watch my review of the Google Data Analysis Certificates, then you can click on the link here or in the description box below. If you found value out of this video, be sure to give it a like and subscribe. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you in the next one.